Hey there, Paracord fans and YouTubers. This is Joe with Paracord Reviews, and today we are going to talk about Paracord bracelets. Specifically, what bracelets give you the most cord and are best for different situations. So today I'm going to cover four popular. This is what some people call the O-ring or D-ring bracelet. We have the serpentine weave. We have your standard cobra. And then this one is the conquistador weave. So what I'm going to do today is go through each one, talk about its pros, its cons, and then also talk about how much cord you get from it and how easy it is to take apart. So with that, let's start with our first one. And that is the O or D ring. For anyone who's put it together, you know it's a pretty simple bracelet. It's basically just a wind, as you can kind of see. It's two pieces wound together. It's an easy bracelet to put together, and actually it's pretty easy to take apart. So now this is a 8 1/4 inch bracelet all the way around. Got my handy dandy measuring tape here. So it's supposed to be pretty easy to take apart. So usually for ones like this, I have put these together for kids, I've known women who tend to like these. They're easy, they're simple, but how much paracord do you really get out of it? So if you were in an emergency situation and you needed paracord, the idea is you should be able to untie one knot, pull it through this loop, and then simply and easily pull. Now, as you can see, that's not happening. I am pulling and pulling, and it's tightening up, but it's not easily coming apart. Now, it loosens up pretty nicely. So in this case, you have to break the seal up here, and that could take some effort. And when I made this one, and I made it specifically for this video, all I did was melt the end. And that's not easily coming apart, so I would have to grab my handy dandy pliers. And even then, if this were an emergency situation, I would be completely failing. But let's just say I'm out in the wilderness and it's not necessarily emergency, but I need cord. I almost melted this one too well, it looks like. Now, if I had a knife, I could just cut this piece and or cut this end and it would be wham bam. I'd be done. But this paracord's living up to its name and being strong. So I have this. I untie it. And then, as you can see, it's just a matter of unrolling it. Now, that's pretty easy. And if that one end wasn't so difficult, this probably would have been very easy to undo. But if you're going to have a bracelet that sticks, you have to continue to roll, or you have to seal it pretty nicely. So there we go. It's completely undone. That took me about 2 minutes or so. Now let's measure this. So this 8 1/4 we're up to 3 feet, 4 feet, 8 1/4 feet. It's getting a little tangly here. All said and done, this gave us a little bit more than, we'll call it about 81 inches. This only goes 79. So not bad. 81 inches. That's just over 6 feet of paracord. That'd be enough to put together possibly a some type of cover, create a fishing line or something like that. So this was the O or D ring. Let's take a look at the serpent. Now normally I would have cut these off, but for the purpose of this video, I left it up. Like I said, I made these yesterday for the video today. Quick, easy undo of a knot. Pull it through. And then with this one. Now, first let's talk about this weave. This is a nice weave. It looks really attractive. I like the pattern. When you do it with two colors, it's very nice. The problem you have with that is it really doesn't hold its shape. It has a lot of play, a lot of additional play. Honestly, I'm not a big fan of this as a bracelet. I like using this weave more to wrap items. But either way. So with this weave, if you make it tight, which you almost need to if it's going to keep its structure, this is not an easy weave to take apart. Each layer is a knot. So you can see here, I'm having to do each one. This is not something I would want in an emergency situation. I wouldn't even want this, honestly, if it was a, you know, I'm not in emergency, but I need some rope. This is, in my mind, a little too much work to get some paracord. And you can see I'm having to undo, and it also twists the heck out of that rope, out of that cord. So I'm going to pause this and I'll come back in a second after this is all done. Okay, I had to pull out the pliers again because some of these knots had worked themselves so tight that I could not get it. So here we go. Now we have the entire thing undone. You can see, as I said, this really kinked the heck out of this cord. So let's go ahead and measure it. A foot, 2 feet, 3 feet, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we're at 79 inches right here. And we're going to bring some of this back, and starting here, so 79 plus 13, that brings us up to 92 inches. So the serpentine weave will give you 13 more inches, or actually, because we said it was about 81, so it'll give you 11 more inches than the D-ring. So that just leaves our last two. The Cobra and the Conquistador. Now, as you guys have seen, I wear the Cobra. I like the Cobra. The difference between these two, I find the Cobra to be a lot stronger. It is, it's not as flexible. It doesn't have as much give. So if you're making something like, say, a strap, or I like to use this for leashes where it's going to get a lot of pull, I find this to be ideal. Now, for straps, you may have to make or do something to give, like for a gunsling. You may have to add some pieces here to make it flare out. Otherwise, this will dig in. Some people will do the double Cobra, which is just two Cobras kind of linked up. That would work too. But if you're looking for something strong that will bend, but is not going to lose its shape, this is for you. The conquistador is very flexible. In fact, this is what I use for my belts. This is our hiker's bracelet that we started selling. It's taken off. I've already sold a couple of them just within the first week. It is very flexible and really morphs, does not hold shape, but it's comfortable too. Whereas the Cobra can be a little constricting. It's personal preference. So let's break this one down. Anybody who's done a Cobra knows exactly how that works. I'm going to go ahead and let's take this apart. Once again, doing the Mad Max style. Since learning that, I have grown to love that style of bracelet. And for those of you who don't know, the Mad Max style is basically a slide bracelet. So let's go ahead, take this one apart, and see what we can see, shall we? Now, the Cobra does not come, it comes apart quicker than the Serpentine. Not as quick as the O-ring. But it will come apart, and you don't necessarily need any tools or knife or anything like that. But you're not going to get it in a couple of seconds. So you can see here, and just using my fingernails. Let me get this out of the way. Just using my fingernails, I am more than able to get this apart. Now, part of this is also on me. I tend to make all my bracelets, all my paracording tight. I prefer that. So I'm going to go ahead and pause, and we'll come back once it's done, okay? Okay, just finishing up here. A couple more loops. And we are done. So this, too, kinks up the cord a lot, as you can see. And it's kind of to be expected. So let's go ahead and measure this one. So 2 feet, no surprise there, considering it was an 8-inch long. So right now, we're looking for it to be 93 to match the other one. So I think we're going to surpass that with 79 right here. Let's go ahead and mark that. And we'll bring back in and start back up. So 79. Already at a foot more. +51, so that is 130. So 130, that is over 10 feet. That's just shy of 11 feet of cord right here. So pretty impressive. So now on to the Conquistador. Once again, another 8-inch. With this one, all you have to do is undo this knot. Let's see if I can get it undone. There we go. One side. And two. Undo that, pull it through, and in theory, you should be able to take this piece out like this. Pull. And then there you go. In 4 seconds, nearly the whole thing was pulled apart. just this little bit of an end here. So, how much cord do we think we have here? Right now, the Cobra Knot is the reigning champion as far as size goes, or as far as length goes. Is this going to be more? So we will see. One thing with this is you do have to, as you can see right there, you do have to melt it a little bit or adhere it. Otherwise, the bottom will come off. So that would be something you would have to deal with. But a little bit of movement and you're good. So let's measure this one. Much like the others, this one kinks up. Honestly, it looks like the D-ring or the O-ring one is the one that doesn't kink up the most. So if that's important to you, if you're worried about that, you know, that may be a way for you to go. So let's go ahead. Okay, so we hit 79 right here. Let's hold that right there and start back up. Okay, so this one added just shy of 52. So we'll call it 51 and a half. So 79 and 51 and a half. So that's 170. So when it comes to them, the Conquistador actually gives you the most with 170, 130, 93, and 81. You know, having a paracord bracelet is good to have no matter what. But it depends on your situation. If you're out hiking and think you want something for emergency, I can't knock the Conquistador. That is my preferred bracelet, and that's why we sell it as our hiker's bracelet. All-purpose, one on as much cord as possible. Can't go wrong with the Cobra. If it'd be nice to have, but you want as much cord as possible, but in an attractive format, the Serpentine is good. And if you just want something basic and simple with a little bit of cord, the O-ring is a good choice for you. No matter what, paracord's good to have. This just gives you a comparison. I hope you like this video. Stay tuned for more. I will tell you, we're moving offices a little bit, so videos for the next couple weeks may be a little light, but I hope you enjoyed this one. Leave comments below, and until then, keep paracording. Bye.